Today we are going to be talking about idols. So first I am going to share my own testimony. So I have three paintings here that I'm going to show you guys. And these pictures kind of describe that I used to really struggle hard with body image. It's a very common thing for typical teenage girls these days because of all the, you know, social media platforms, comparison. It can be hard living in this day and age. I mean, let's be real. So I painted some pictures to kind of represent myself and how I was building and getting closer to God and realizing about that I am beautiful and that I am who God says I am, and just realizing that having a perfect facade, you know, how I think I'm supposed to look like, is like an idol to God, for really it's blocking me in my fellowship, in my relationship with God. And I feel like this was really an idol for me that I had. So this picture really speaks a lot because it is me in a vulnerable state and when I'm just really struggling and I feel like there's no one there and God isn't there and the world is just against me and Satan is in my head. This is a picture of how I feel. So then this painting is the second painting of my series. And so this one is a picture of me eventually coming out of my shell and feeling a little better about myself, but still not quite there. And then this next picture, really, I feel like this picture just represents me when, as an individual, when I just feel content in God and I just feel in a close relationship and bond with God, and I can stand firm against anything coming my way. That's really what this picture here speaks to myself, that God is in her and she can do anything and she will not fail. Just me from the hurting and growing and God shaping me to really just start to understand the value God has placed on me. So I tend, and I know a lot of people do, fulfilling, we are human beings, people. Like, we are in search of love because we are not from this planet. And so our souls are constantly trying to find fulfillment with either money or friends and wealth and relationships. There are so many things we can put as an idol in front of God and how he speaks to us and how he should make us feel and how our relationship should be with God. There are so many different things that could block us and be an idol that we might not even realize it. Especially in this world, we are human beings and we are constantly searching to find a place where we are loved, to be feeling belonged and approved and accepted. Those are all great feelings, and I feel like those things are what we're really searching for. And so we look in the wrong places and we go to the wrong places to find fulfillment, but it doesn't last forever, and we end up hurting in the end. Recognize, reflect yourself constantly. You know, God speaks to us and tells us to reflect yourself because Satan is walking around trying to pounce on you like a lion. There's so many things that can get us off track and make us feel loved, but then in the end not work out, and earthly things, just earthly happiness just does not last. And God specifically tells us in this verse, John 2:16, "For all that is in the world, the desires of flesh and the desires of eyes and pride and possession, is not from the Father, but from the world." And so I feel like we really have to recognize those earthly flesh desires that we have, and we have to, you know, think about them and control. The Bible is literally a construction manual for life. I mean, he has it all right there. So if you look at this verse, Galatians 5:19 through 21, you know, put it in modern terms. Do you have a relationship blocking you with your walk in God? Is your body image and your thoughts about yourself blocking your walk with God? And all these things, these idols that you're putting in front of you, are they blocking your walk with God, and are they going to last forever? These things will not last, and he specifically says in 1 John 2:17, "The world is passing away along with its desires, and whoever does the will of God abides in him." This verse just really speaks to me because these things that we worry about constantly and that are making us anxious are going to pass away, and we have to just constantly focus, even when we get set off track, that we have to come back, you know, refocus that lens and think, what am I doing for the will of God and what does he want me to do for him? Fill your soul up with the true source of happiness that is eternal and everlasting. So when you feel down and when you feel like there's a struggle or when you feel that someone's working out or that you aren't enough and that you aren't accepted, come back. And God will carry you back in and listen to his words, listen to what he's telling you, and you will feel full and just rejuvenated with joy for what he has for you. God wants us to be alert about the things going on within us, and so know that you don't understand God's ways, but know that the suffering is for a purpose. Know that you are not alone, and God loves you, and there's fellowship and people around you who are dealing with the same exact things, and everyone in this world has something. Know that God's got your back and know that he was always there for you, and if you focus on him and seek him, he will pursue you back. Anyways guys, that is it for my sermon, and thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it made an impact on you in some way, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys!